Hi everyone, welcome and welcome back to our YouTube channel. I am Fatina from Ras Aquaculture. In the last video of our pond-based shrimp farming update, we showed you guys of our first PL stocking. In this video, we will update you guys about the shrimp and also the progress of our farm after a month since the PL stocking. Stay tuned! Hello everyone! It's been nearly 2 months since we released the PLs into our pond. The water level in the pond has also risen from about 1.5 feet to 2.5 feet, reaching our chest level. So it's actually quite deep, particularly in the center of the pond. As you can see, the pond no longer has as much floating algae as it once did because the water is no longer as shallow. In addition, we used probiotics and increased the turbidity of the water to reduce algae production in the pond. We also have been monitoring the pond's water quality from day to day for the shrimp's healthy growth. From the last water quality check in the morning, the salinity is 20 ppt with 4 ppm dissolved oxygen level and 0 NH4, which is ammonia. In the evening, meanwhile, the dissolved oxygen level increases to 8 ppm from 4 ppm due to photosynthesis from the algae. As you can see over here, my colleague is preparing the shrimp feed by mixing the enzyme and probiotic in the pellet to feed the shrimp 3 times daily at an average weight of 11 kg pellet per meal. So probiotics are actually added to help the shrimp's immune system and survival, while the enzyme aids in the feed conversion process. So this is my colleague circling the pond feeding the shrimp. We put a little bit of the pellet on the feeding tray at each edge of the pond so we can catch the shrimp for a daily check and see how much the shrimp ate. Here's a look at most of our shrimp in the pond since the PL stocking. They have grown to a size of 6 to 8 centimeters. Every day we will check the shrimp size and gut to see if they are eating well. However, aside from the white leg shrimp, we found other shrimp species in the pond which might come in as juvenile. It's about the size of PLH and we have already gotten a small shrimp with eggs inside. We placed the shrimp in a container filled with a pellet to see if they ate it or not, given their small size. But turns out, they don't actually eat the pellet, but rather play with it. We will conduct additional testing on the shrimp to determine the species. Despite putting a net on the pipe, they may come from the river where we get our water to fill the pond. More farm update, we are currently cleaning up another pond by removing the sludge. Because the sludge is quite thick, it is difficult to remove it from the pond. The reason for the removal is to ensure that the shrimps are free from EMS and EHP disease. A better option would be to install a HDPE liner, but we are experimenting with other options that we have before proceeding to install a liner. And that's all for today's pond-based farm makeover and update. If you enjoyed this video and want to see more videos like this, leave us a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Feel free to check out our free ebooks in the description box below. Hope to see you in the next video. Bye!